11 criteria. Only then we can diagnose it as specific learning disability. Okay, so IQ test is very important. Then there is a diagnosis test of learning disability by Smriti Swarup and an enhanced index for specific learning disability. And all these tests will take time. So we have to give appointment. If you are doing the test by yourself, we have to give a different time appointment for the child. Because we, what I do in my clinic is we send this for the psychologist if the test is needed, especially if an IQ test is needed, we need a certificate also. So we send the child for a clinic to a clinical psychologist for the test and certification to be done. For us to understand, we can do this test in our clinic and we can understand where the child is, which area that we have to focus while training the child. Okay. Because the outcome is very important. We have to, why we have to do and specifically we have to reach diagnosis, then only we'll know what is the outcome of the case. By the 20 years, what the child will be. Then in the if there is a problem in reading, writing and speaking and all, we have to test for language delays. We have to do tests for language delays, like REEves, that is receptive, expressive, emergent scale and language scale, less. There's so many tests for languages, SLD screening tool, all that you have to do. And when you reach diagnosis, Dr. Rekha, you got the slide? I've been going on telling. It's the 97th slide, not this is all we told last time.
No, ma'am, I have a download. You haven't sent it in the mail.
Okay.
On the 4, which I have sent? It's not there.
What was the name of this file? Just tell me.
No, you have sent the file. Four files you had sent. Assessment, yeah. Assessment of maths, English, this one and the other one. All these four.
What was the name of this file?
No, it was separate. All the four separate files.
Separate files, huh?
Yeah.
Okay. This is learning disorder, isn't it?
Yeah.
How many slides are there in this? How many slides are there? Total number of slides?
Yeah, it is there. 97, I think.
Diagnosis. Yeah, that one I was talking about.
You can see, I guess, IQ test.
IQ test. That's what I was telling. IQ test that you have to do. See that draw a man test. That's a simple test. You ask a child to draw a man. Man means draw a child, because child will know only to draw a child. And you that how to calculate this test you can buy it. I think it is there available in Bangalore in Psychotronics. That shop is called Psychotronics. It is available there. When you draw a child, you have to how many parts he has drawn. That's how we calculate the IQ. It can be done easily while we take the case. You can ask the child to give a paper to the child and ask the child to draw a child. Okay. You can know the IQ, the difference in IQ. In any child, you can do that. You can know how a child with an IQ will draw all the parts of the child. The eyes, nose, ears, lips, neck, hand, leg, and all the child. And if the child has low IQ, he'll draw only the face. There won't be an eye, there won't be a nose. You can try this in your clinic, and it's very easy also. It's not time consuming. And the understanding or taking the reading is also very easy. Okay, this you can try with any child in your clinic. Then the BKT and all will take time. That is Pinai Kama test. Then VISC also, MISC, everything will take more time. You'll have to give a prior appointment and 1 hour, 2 hours, you'll have to wait for one child, give for one child while you do this test. Okay. The diagnosis test for learning disability by Smriti Swarup will take, I think, more than 2 hours. And an enhanced index for specific learning disability will also take that much time. So I'll tell don't waste your time doing tests, because our work is not diagnosing, like doing the tests and for certification. We are from a physician's point of view, when I tell we for us prescribing is more, but we have to know all this. Without knowing this, we can't, our prescription will go wrong. Okay, we have to know where the exact position of the child. You can outsource it, like you can send to a psychologist and ask this test to be done and send back. Okay. or you can have a psychologist. I had a psychologist in my clinic before. Now he's not in Calicut. Now he's in Hans, working in Hans. So I have not appointed a new one. When he was there, I'll give him an appointment, and when the child comes, he will do the test so that we didn't waste that time. And after all this test is done, what we have to do, okay? What we have to do. See the next slide, Dr. Rekha, next slide. What we have to do, the next slide. Yeah, what we have to do. We have done all the tests, language tests, IQ tests, and everything we have done, and we have reached the diagnosis. Now what we have to do? Okay. This is a, the next slide. There's a need for a management strategies, that like multi-modal approach. Yeah? Okay, we have to do the medical intervention, remedial measures, psychological approach, and the social and administrative approach. Medical interventions we have to do for sure. The other ones, what we can do is an occupational therapy. If there is a real, next slide. Occupational therapy, if there is a real problem in the coordination. Okay. Breathing exercise, like last time you heard Dr. Veena, that was a wonderful class, Dr. Veena's. The breathing exercise and yoga therapy and counseling for parents, that's very important, because unless the parent understands the child, all the work we do in our clinic will be wasted when the child goes back.
Anjali.
Oh, sorry, not Veena. Sorry, Anjali. Sorry. Sorry. Anjali. Yeah, Anjali. Okay. And here we do one more thing. We do a group therapy, because all these parents come together to our clinic, and we make them sit together and we do a group therapy. That's very effective group therapy, because they know. They can know each other, how a parent approaching the child, because they'll have similar problems, isn't it? So parents are best teachers, okay? So some parents are very creative. So they can share their feelings, and group therapy is, I think it's very effective. We take 10 or 15 parents together, and once in a month we give a training session, whole day, or a half day, how the time allows, okay? And we give them a session, we give them yoga, them breathing, and understanding their child and how the remedial this works, and all that we teach in that group session. Okay, next is the next slide. Next is medical interventions. Where medicine has to act. Okay, brain maturation and attention. Brain maturation, we have our medicine have to work there, and the correction of the attention, that endocrine function. I think I forgot to mention last time also. This thyroid and growth hormone is both are very much needed for a learning to happen properly. In of late, like last three or four years, I have seen many more cases with the growth hormone deficiency. I don't know why it is happening, because when I started my career, I hadn't seen that much cases with the growth hormone deficiency. But now we see more cases with growth hormone deficiency. So endocrine function is very important, and metabolic correction, seizure management. I think last time somebody had asked a question about seizure management. Okay, that all these are important when we think of a medical intervention. Next slide. Remedial measures. We have to do an individualized remedial protocol, and where to, how, at what level we have to do an intervention, because a smaller child at the age of 5 to 6 years, we have to assess whether the child has all the ready to study skills. When the child is about 10 years, we have to see whether the child has attained all the study skills. Then by 12 to 13 years, we have to see whether the child has attained the academic skills. And by 14 to 16, they have to attain the life skills. That is the aim of our education, that attaining life skills. Okay. So you can, if we want, we can see all these skills in separate. Okay, ready to study skills, there are almost more than 100. I think 112 of them. Study skills are 12 of them, and academic skills are almost that much. Life skills has been life skills and study skills have been put forth by WHO also. What the child has to attain after they finish their schooling. I think in CBSE schools there. They have given teachers, all the teachers training for life skill training, and the teachers has to train the children for their life skills, to attain their life skills. Okay. So life skills are also there. And if you are interested, we can do sessions on that also. Ready to study skills will take more time because there are more than 112 of them. Okay. And if any, I can give you one or two examples for you to understand. It is understanding color and understanding position, understanding time. Okay. This ready to study skills. This skills child has to attain from 3 to 6 years. That is in their kindergarten, they have to actually attain these skills. But unfortunately, in kindergartens, they go in for reading and writing, and they don't have time to attain these skills. At home also, children don't have time. Because maybe they are living in flats, they don't play much, they don't run about and play in the courtyard. Okay, and they go to school and start reading and writing. And if these skills are not attained, that 112 of them, they are not attained, the child has problem in learning. I can mention a few of them, because once the child doesn't know the color, shape and size, he cannot read, write or do mathematics. Because color is pre-reading, pre-writing, pre-mathematics. Shape is a pre-reading, pre-writing and a pre-mathematics skill. And if these two are not attained, the child will have difficulty in reading and writing. So when a child is brought to us 5 to 6 years, we have to assess whether the child has attained all these study skills. Okay. Similarly, I mean, ready to study skills. And the study skills are I think it's there in the slide. Time management, okay. Time management, able to set goals, concentration, coordination, executive skills, organization skills. Organization skill is very important, because we have to have all the materials for study. When we are sitting for studying, they should have the text, they should have the notes, and they should have the, in these conditions, we have to have a PC or a lap or a phone or anything, Google with them. Okay, so things should be organized before they start studying. If you don't have this organization skills, when the child is sitting for studying, you don't have the text, you don't have the notes, don't have the pencil, no pen, anything, nothing is there. So such skills are important. And also the organization skill is important while we write exam. For example, like if you have an essay to write, a 400 word essay or a 300 word essay, we have to organize the whatever we have learned, like the introduction, the main theme and the conclusion. Like we have to organize our essay. So a child is lacking this organization skill, giving answers to the question won't happen. He'll write so many things and it won't be an organized answer. Okay. So these study skills, by the child reach 10 to 11 years, these study skills are attained by him. Okay. And the next slide, please. Psychological interventions. What a parent and a teacher can do. That is acceptance and positive regard. Firmness. See, firmness without anger is actual love. The parents in yesteryears, they were very firm. And the children grown in that time, they were, performed better than the children, at least emotionally. They were better than the children of these days, because the parents nowadays are not firm. Okay, firmness without anger is actual love to the child. And it will help the child with an emotional EQ to develop EQ. The firmness of a parent is very important. Clarity of expression and clear instruction. That when we talk to the child, when you have when the parent and the child is in conversation, you have, the parent has to give clear instruction and the child has to be given responsibility also. Only then he will have the responsibility for learning, for studying by himself. Especially the learning disabled child, what he does is he runs away from studying. He doesn't take the responsibility of learning or performing in exams. That responsibility mostly lay with the parent. And there's a tug of war between the parent and the child. Okay, when the responsibility shifted to the child, at least he will start thinking that I should work. Until then, the mother is working and he has just go and write the exam. Okay, That's what happens at, when the child has a problem at home. So you have, the parent has to shift the responsibility to the child. That, you know, we have to teach the parent that we do in the group therapy. So the shifting of responsibility happens, because mostly when the child has a problem, parents protect the child so much that they take the responsibility of anything the child has to do, the parent doesn't do. Child has no responsibility. Okay. And another thing, the next slide, please. The thing we have to give the child is a winning experience, because he'll be at loss everywhere. In the school, at the home, the parent will be scolding, at school, the teachers will be scolding, no marks, low marks, all mistakes. So a winning experience, if you can make him have a winning experience, that will build his self-confidence so much. So we can have a variety of competitions in class to be done. Not just the usual ones. Anything the child is capable of, we can do a competition in that and make the child win. So that winning, when you give a winning experience, will have a lot of confidence and he'll try to overcome his problems by himself. Okay. Realistic, keep realistic expectations. That's for the parent. Yes, they have to keep a realistic expectation and they have to be a model and they have to listen to the child. What the child has to say, even you have to, we have to. When the child comes to a clinic, you have to talk to the child separately from the parent. Whatever the parent says, let them tell anything. But what you have to listen to what the child has to say. Okay. And that is to be done without the parent. Parent has to sit outside and you talk to the child. And they will tell you a lot of things. The child, if anybody is there to listen to him with empathy, he'll tell a lot of things. Okay, just listen to them. They'll give you the way how to find solutions for his problems. The child will teach us a lot of things. But if you have time in your clinic, talk to the child separately. And when you give an appointment, you make it a point that you will have enough time to interact with the child. That will give us so many insights. Now the next slide, please. This is the therapeutic intervention. I think I showed this slide last time. Selection of a potency also, I think I mentioned last time. Because I start with higher potencies only. Because the learning disabled child is an intelligent child. And he has the problem in his interneuronal connections or in the synaptic connections or the gene expressions in the brain or the myelination problem or something like that in these networks. Okay. So we have to surely go in for higher potencies because we have to get the action in neurons. And the medicines I use commonly, I think tuberculinum I forgot to write. I think I told last time also. I've not changed the slide to the same slide. And we have, I'll tell you a few cases I have done. Okay, one child, there was one child who had difficulty in reading, writing. He was, when he came to us, he was, I think, 6 years of age. And at birth, he had a problem with this, he had cardiac problems. And the surgery was done. Now he's okay with his cardiac problem. And he was brought in for his learning. He had difficulty in reading, writing, and doing calculations. And he was brought, we took the case. We found it to be sorenam. Okay, he was so sweating. He was angry. He was irritable. He was hungry like that. Night he used to have food, lots of food. So sorenam was given 1 m. Okay, and we had to repeat it because after a few days, it's gone. After 2-3 weeks, its anger will come back. Okay, so when you used to repeat the sorenam after 3 weeks, 1 m, 1 dose, or a divided dose we give, 1 dose divided into 2, and we give 1 dose at night and next dose in the morning. Same dose divided into 2. Okay, I repeated it in 3 weeks. By the time it will take long time. Okay, learning disability children, it take lots of time to get corrected. And we gave a remedial training also here, and he had problem in language also. The speech language pathologist also worked with him, and the remedial teacher also worked with him, and I gave him that all happened in our clinic only. And he came medicine, and by the time he came at, I think, 6 years, by the time he was 8 years, he could read and write well up to the level of 8 years. Okay, so where we have to intervene, where at what level we have to give intervention is at the level the child is functioning. See, whether the child is 6 years or 7 years, whether the child is at the level of the alphabet, we have to start the remedial training at the level of the alphabet. Okay, not the 7 years. 7 years of child has to read sentences. No, we can't work like that. we have to find out the level functioning of the child and start working from there. So this child, by 8 years, he was started reading, writing his grade level. He reached his grade level. That was, he was in, I think 8 years means he must be in 4th standard by then. Now he's in 5th standard. The other day he was brought here. Two or three days back, he was brought here for his, he had some cold or something, headache or something like that. Now he's better, he's functioning properly. But in between, now they have, I think we have stopped giving remedial training and medicine for the last 1 year. The grandmother told me he started showing anger. So I had asked her to come here after his cold is over and we'll again take the case and see the medicine. Like that we go. Okay, then I'll tell you a case of I think it is Lakapodiyam. Yeah, Lakapodiyam. And there was another child. He had he can write alphabets and words, but when it reached to sentences and doing calculation, he had a problem. So he was given remedial training. That language intervention was not needed. Speech pathologist was not needed. Only a special educator was needed. So we started with the remedial training and we gave Lycopodium. And again, it was, I think, 1 month. We started with 1 month. Slowly, after 1 month, 2 months, I think I gave 10 mg once in a month for 5 or 6 months, I think. Then the child has improved a lot. His anger, his irritability was gone. His food habits came to normal. He started taking proper diet. This child is not had not eaten properly before that, and started going to school regularly. Started studying on his own. Okay, the parent was relieved much, and this was started with Lycopodium 1 mg and finished by Lycopodium 10 mg. It had taken, I think, almost 1 year. Take that much time. Okay, the child to change and come to a grade level of functioning, and all these children were IQ were normal. When this IQ is less, you have to go for other medicines. Okay, not just these medicines. Then I have seen lot of cases improving with Kaustika, the problem in language. Okay, then Calcarea Carb and Calcarea Force, both the remedies have given very much help. Even Natremor, how you decide on Natremor is we look for the, I mean, cravings, the child is hot or the something like that, and decide on the medicine. Sepia. And somebody had asked me last time whether you can give sepia for children. The sepia, I think the sepia, we give sepia even Natremor, both for depression also. In depression also and in this learning problem also, the problem is there by the dopamine levels are low. Even in ADHD also, dopamine levels are low. So when we give sepia, I think the sepia must be acting in the gene expressions. And that's how it's getting corrected. Gene expressions, the proteins produced by the genes, it must be going there and correcting it. I think we have to redefine our, understand our medicines a little more at molecular level to understand where the medicine is going and acting. And the diseases also, we have to understand the diseases or the pathology of each disease is at the molecular level so that we can understand how our medicine is going and acting at that level. So all these medicines which we give should be acting in the nervous system. We have to select medicines accordingly, and we have to be sure that there's an action in the neurons. Okay, only then we'll get an action. There are so many mistakes also I have made. Like one child was brought, the first child I saw with a learning problem, I didn't know what it was. I never understood what the child was saying or what the mother was saying. That was in 2001. Okay, that was the first child. I'll never forget her in my life. And another child, then I took her to my trainer, and then I understood. Then I gave medicine, but the child was a low IQ child, mild mental retardation. It was mild mental retardation. So we had to send her to special school after she completed her 4th in a regular school. Then she couldn't go further because after 4th standard, if you have to learn. You have to have a certain amount of IQ. Only then what we have learned, the basics what we learned in up till 4th standard can be applied in 5th and 6th standard. Okay, she had a mild mental retardation. She is one of the twin. The other twin was okay, and she went to regular school, and this child was shifted to a special school. Okay, then that's how we came by making mistakes only. I learned so many things by making mistakes only. And so many of them, the first prescription had gone wrong and nothing happened. So many medicines had gone wrong many a time had gone wrong. Then what happens is they come back to us for the remedial training and special education and all that. Then we can have time to retake the case and understand it properly and then select the proper medicine. Sometimes I make mistakes. Even now, sometimes I make mistakes. And we learn again, we take the case again and see the simulivum again. And like that we give. And intercurrent also we give madoranum, cefalinum and all. Okay, as intercurrents once in a while. The next slides also, I think I showed it last time. Like Dr. Rekha, the next slide, please. This is how the words misplacing. You can read it for yourself. Lacklinum, antimon, lacobody, stramonium, and the stramonium also had one girl. She had an IQ of only about 75. But the mother, you know, she works hard with the child and she got over a 10th and she joined the plus one. And I used to tell her, you don't put her in a CBSE school, put her in a state board school where the exams are more simpler. But the mother somehow, she didn't want that. And she used to send the child to the CBSE school itself. Okay. And when she got through her plus one also. Then in the plus two, what happened is she failed. And she couldn't accept that failure. Then she didn't get out. She never went out of her own. She was drawn inside herself. And she couldn't accept this failure. That indication we gave stramonia. She overcome it. And she wrote the exam next time and she got over. Then she couldn't do a further study. Now I think she's learning some computer or something. 75 IQ means she cannot expect to go beyond much of a learning. She has to learn some vocational and start working as soon as possible. So her father was working with the taxation like that, no? With CA. I don't know whether he is a completed CE or something. He used to work as an accountant. So he thought teaching her accountancy, she'll be able to. In the beginning itself, I used to tell her, you don't think of that. But for her, accountancy will be a big problem. Then IQ of 75, you can't expect a child to understand the laws of taxation and all that. Okay. So, but they were trying, they were forcing the child somehow to learn accountancy and to make her work in their own office. Then I told her, you teach her computer so that she can help in that way. At least typing and calculating that softwares are available. All the calculations can do that. And they send her to an ITA to learn the basics of the computer course. And they didn't come back to me. Now, I think she is learning that. When there's a problem, they'll come back. This child used to come to us in a very early itself, I think, very early type of. Like in our fourth standard, fifth standard. Every time they come, we make them understand parents and all this stuff. This only 75 IQ, she won't be able to. But the parents will expect, you know, it's there anyway. So they were taxing the child to learn. At one stage, she broke down completely. There's a stramonium that helped her to come back to life. Okay. Then, like that, there are many cases, just lots of medicine giving wonderful effects. But it's not a miracle. I won't say that. It's never a miracle. Homeopathy is never a miracle. I don't use that word miracle. It's because we don't know how a medicine acts. We think it's a miracle. But it's not a miracle. It's very logical. And I think when you start studying our medicines at a molecular level and the diseases at a molecular level, we'll get an insight. Even the other day, I was listening to a Zoom webinar. The doctor was telling he had done the study of Cali bike. So he's thinking that when you 200 potency, the Cali bike will act in the digestive system. And when it is a 30 potency, it is better for a respiratory system. That's what he had found from his experience and how it acts in the gene expression. All he studied that medicine in depth. Okay, and that if you try to learn our medicines and the diseases into a molecular level, I think we can get a better results in our practice with each of these medicines, how it acts and which areas act. I think for learning disability also, we'll have to we can for reading specifically for reading specifically for writing and all we can get exact specific medicine will be it will be possible for us when you know it, when we know the pathology also at the with the molecular level. The pathology also we don't know much. Only the science has reached a stage where they understand there are gene expressions of proteins which help in the lateralization of the neurons and myelination of the neurons. Only that much. It's just the specific one they have yet to find out. Only few of them they have found out. Not all. There are some you can some related topics you can search in the net to get also. You want you can read also that how the gene expressions in each neurodevelopment conditions is there. Few of them they have found out. Okay, then we know that medicines also act at the molecular level. You can understanding homeopathy medicines will be a it will become more easier when we know that this is at a molecular level. Okay, what any doubt? If you have any doubt, you can ask regarding the potency. I start with the higher potency only in a learning disabled child. When it is a mild mental retardation or even other developmental disorder, it can start at 200. Even then, I never go to a mother teacher in these cases. Okay, I never go to a mother teacher or six or I don't know. Some doctors say they do, but I never used. Okay, I never used. I use only above 200 and above. If they have other diseases, because these children will have a respiratory infection, they can have fever, they can have a viral infection, then we can come with a higher potency, or even if you want the child has cough, you can give a tincture and all that. But for these specific neurological conditions, I think we have to start at least from 200 only. If you have any doubt, you can ask. I have sent a slide to, it's not a slide, it's a word file, how the assessments of mathematics and English to be done. If you want, you can discuss that. If you have time and if we have the Zoom also allows it, you can.
This session.
Hello, Dr. Rekha.
Anubha, ma'am, can I ask you one question? I am Dr. Manu.
Yes, sir.
Manu. Hello, Dr. Manu.
Ma'am, have you experience with serophilum medicines like serophilum,
where the letters
get reversed and all? We have read it in
I have heard about the medicine. I have not used it. I'll try next time and I'll tell you, let you know. Okay, have you tried that medicine?
No, I haven't tried. I just read about that.
You have? I too read about it, but I haven't tried. I don't have that medicine in my pharmacy. I don't use that much rare. I work with the polycystic itself mostly. And Dr. Rekha tells so many medicines, I wonder, these medicines are there in a veterinary. Isn't it Rekha? Dr. Rekha?
Yeah, ma'am. Actually, we come across so many remedies, we'll be liking to try all those medicines. So we read about it. So
it's good also.
Yeah.
No, when you try, record it and you tell us also how to use. Okay.
Any other questions? Please ask, ma'am. You were talking about CP children, ma'am. What level you will be able to help them? Or how you know that this child
when IQ is intact, it is here. You have to see the IQ. Okay, just test for the given test for IQ test. Okay.
Yes.
Are you understood?
Yeah.
Dr. Rekha, you give an IQ test and